The pathways going from the emotional brain to the intellect and the human brain are like a six-lane superhighway going in one direction. Whoosh, tons of data. But the pathways going from the intellect to the emotional brain are like a little teeny path in the forest. So what does this mean? We are deeply emotional beings. 90% of our decisions, behaviors, etc., are driven, are dominated, important word, by our emotional brain. So we have to be very aware of the fact that our people are emotional beings, that we are emotional beings, and this is why it's super important to understand resilience, okay? So let's do a really quick review of the brain. Those of you who were here yesterday, thanks for bearing with me. Three key areas of the brain that we're concerned with in leadership. Reptilian brain, mammalian brain, and the neocortex / prefrontal cortex. Reptilian brain, stimulus response machine, trying to keep us safe, physical safety. The reptilian brain is responsible for breathing, temperature regulation, life support systems, if you will. If the reptilian brain could speak, it would say dead or not. It did not say alive or not, okay? So no concept of quality of life in the reptilian brain. It is all about staying, not dead, okay? Next, mammalian brain. This is staying safe, if you will, being safe emotionally, okay? So physical in the reptilian, emotional in the mammalian. The mammalian brain is where we have anger, fear, love, happiness, peace. It's where we have the hippocampus, which is responsible for learning and memory, which is why when we have emotion around learning and memory, it sticks better, okay? If our company values are emotional and inspiring, people will remember them and live by them. The mammalian brain, reptilian brain is also where we have the limbic system, fight, flight, freeze response. It does kind of overlap both, right? So if the mammalian brain could speak, it would say friend or foe. A little bit more evolved than dead or not, but still, stimulus response machine trying to keep you safe. Next, prefrontal cortex, right behind your forehead, if you will, part of the neocortex, most evolved part of being a human being. Dogs, cats, people always ask me, yes, have a prefrontal cortex. Dogs are bigger than cats, based on you're a dog or a cat fan. And the coolest part about the prefrontal cortex is that this is where we have decision making. This is where we have vision. This is where we have language, tool making. This is where we have the ability to say, I'm here, but I want to be there. How exactly am I going to get there? Now, here's the problem though. The good point and then the problem. Good point, if the prefrontal cortex could speak, it would say, what can I create? Okay, the problem part though, is that when we're under stress, we don't have availability or access to the prefrontal cortex. We're in lockdown. We're in what we call critter state.